that game was crazy. Another overtime game. How do you summarize the resolve that we saw from you guys second period on?
Yeah, what a roller coaster. It was just one of those games like the last one, like game one. A lot of fun. You know, obviously we had some issues with their power play, but our power play responded, guys responded, and we're a resilient hockey club. And we got two big wins on the road, and we're only going to build off that from here.
And let's talk about the penalty kill a little bit, because that third period was a little rugged. You guys were out there a lot.
Yeah, too much. You know, we talked about being disciplined. You know, whether we love the calls or not, you got to go kill them. And, you know, I thought we did a great job at certain times of the game. Obviously gave up that one late. But, you know, we'll keep learning. They got a great PP, and we'll just keep trying to get better and keep that puck over net.
Thomas Vanek said after game one that there was a calm between the third and the overtime. Was it the same tonight?
It was. You know, we were in a little different situation. We had the game all wrapped up with about 5 minutes to go, and gave up the lead. But we went in there, and boys were smiling. They were ready to go. They were excited for, another chance to be a hero.
So let's talk about the overtime. Folks at home, you may not believe this, but I said it's going to be Matt Calvert like about 30 seconds before you scored. Did you have a feel for it as you entered that zone?
You know what? Not really. I just seen Orpik going and get the puck, and you're kind of tired in OT, but I decided to lay the body, and usually good things happen when you do that. And I don't know if Andy or Doobie got it. They threw it to Z, and Z's got a lot of talent. He made a great play, and I'm hanging out back door, and it comes to me. I only had one hand on my stick, and I was able to chip it past him. So great to see it go in, but more important, the big win, and up 2-0 in the series.
And then the drama of having to wait. Did you know for sure you were onside there?
Yeah, I honestly had no idea. I knew it was close when Andy crossed the line, but I thought it was over. I was getting mobbed by the boys, and all of a sudden I see the refs checking it out. So, you wait, but we got to see it on video replay. The fans are pretty quiet, so you got to think it was onside, and it was great to see them call it.
Goals are goals, but compare this one to that overtime winner you had in Pittsburgh a couple years ago.
Yeah, this one's bigger. It gives us a 2-0 lead going home. Our fans are hungry and waiting. We've seen a lot on social media. We've seen what they're like in playoffs, and we can't wait to get home. Obviously you look for a split, ideally on the road, but we got two, and now we got to go back to work for game three.
Matty, you've been around this organization for a long time. Can you imagine that building on Tuesday night when you guys take the ice up 2-0 in the Stanley Cup playoff series?
I can't wait, but it's going to be another fresh start to the game, yep. And we're going to use our fans. It's a lot of momentum shifts, and I thought their fans were great tonight, and we did a great job battling through them. So we're going to use that to our advantage, and I can't wait to play in front of them.